and working for Ronald Reagan. And when he came in, people, the conservatives said there was a double standard. And you know what? Because he was transparent, because he respected the press, because he treated people civilly, he got very fair coverage. It was not as biased as anything like this. It was not as slugfest you're seeing today. But Reagan set a standard of civility in the White House, and you believed in that.
Yes.
That really worked for him and really changed it. This is not just a product, oh, the terrible liberal press. There is something more going on here that has a lot to do with the man who was running the operation. The signals come down from the top.
I do think that there was enormous resistance. That, I mean, the phrase that was applied to this one group of people that I think can be used in a lot of ways, never Trump. I really do think that Donald Trump, for one reason or another, has stirred such wrath with elites in Washington, in both parties,
If you start out hating people, they will hate you back. And he started out hating people right from the get-go.
But we have elections for this purpose, the decisions made, and to keep this kind of thing going is, I think, a mistake.
He didn't send out tweets. He sent the tweets today. He's not the misogynist.
This is one of the peculiarities of covering this White House. I mean, honestly, I think that there's two things here, and one is that it's not that we're covering a White House that plays by different rules. It's that we're covering a president who tends to play by no rules whatsoever, and he makes up the rules as he goes along. And some days they work in his favor, and some days they work in other people's favor.
Which is probably why he won.
It's why he was effective in business real estate for a really long time. I mean, that's absolutely true. He is a guy who makes deals, and he treats everything as if it's a big deal. And it's just a little different here. But the other is there is this sort of distortive quality that David's really speaking to, which is, he did this. I mean, yes, it is true. Mika Brzezinski criticized him. That is definitely true. But Mika Brzezinski is not the president, and these remarks don't have equal weight when they are delivered from each of them, because one is the president and one isn't. And so he will say something or he will do something, and it will always come down to the response from his folks will always be, well, he felt attacked, or, you know, they attacked him, or, you know, he didn't do this. And it's you're getting sort of half of the page as opposed to the
full
page.
Also, Jen, I mean, I wonder how much of this is that, you know, as a civilian, as a businessman in New York, Donald Trump was used to, you know, positive tabloid coverage because he was calling up reporters pretending to be a spokesperson and, you know, selling his own stories and planting stories and stuff and leaking stuff. But the idea of, you know, a critical press that every White House feels the press is critical of them, and they should be. I mean, that is the role of the press, to be critical. I mean, sure, there's some networks that which, you know, want to be an organ of the White House, it seems, but or just an avowed enemy of the White House. But, you know, most reporters want to be fair and accurate and try very hard just to be that.